Hello, this is a small discussion on an MCQ from topic multiple gestation. So this is the question. You have successfully finished conducting a vaginal twin delivery and you're asked to examine the placenta, the picture of which is given below. From this picture, can you predict regarding the sex of the babies? The options are both babies will be of same sex, both babies will be of different sex, both babies can be of same or different sex, and the last option is cannot predict by placental examination alone. So this question needs to be cracked in two steps. The first step is we need to identify what type of twin gestation this is. And the second step, we need to know what kind of gender combinations can be seen in that kind of twin gestation. So let's look at the picture first. You can observe that there is placenta number 1 and placenta number 2, two totally different placentas, and in the center there is a chorionic membrane and there are two amniotic membrane on each side. So we can summarize by saying that there are two separate placentas and there's a chorionic membrane between the two amnion. So from these findings, we can definitely say that this is dichorionic because there are two separate placentas, and diamniotic because there are two amniotic sacs. So what kind of gender combinations are possible in DCDA type of twins? For this, we need to understand how twin gestations happen. Basically, twin gestation happens because of two types of conception. The first is dizygotic, where always DCDA type of twins are formed. The second is monozygotic twinning, where depending on the division that happens within a particular number of days, there can be four outcomes: DCDA, MCDA, MCMA, and conjoint. So you can note that in both types of twinnings, the DCDA type is common. Please note that chorionicity and amniocity can be detected from examination, clinical examination, placental examination, and ultrasound findings, but the zygosity of the baby can only be determined through DNA studies. So let's look at this dichorionic diamniotic type. As already discussed in the previous slide, this can happen because of dizygotic conception or monozygotic conception. Let's start with the easier one. In monozygotic conception, there is one egg which gets fertilized by one sperm, which can be 23X or Y, which leads to formation of one zygote, which can be a girl or a boy, depending on what type of karyotype the sperm is. If this zygote divides within the next 3 days, it forms DCDA twins. If it divides after 3 days, it can form MCDA, MCMA, or conjoint, depending on which day it divides. So from this, we can come to a conclusion that all monozygotic twin will always be of same sex, whereas in dizygotic twin, there are two ovums which gets fertilized by two separate sperms, each of which can be 23X or Y. This leads to formation of two zygotes, each of which can be a boy or a girl. So the two fetus can be fetus girl and girl, or girl and boy, or the first baby girl and the second baby boy. So we can conclude that in dizygotic twinning, the babies can be of same or different sex. So in toto, we can say that DCDA twins can be of same or different sex. Now coming back to the question, from the previous slides, we can come to a conclusion that the answer is C. Both babies can be of same or different sex, because in this question the zygosity is not mentioned. So as an umbrella rule, we can say DCDA twins can be of same or different sex. So this is a small summary of the presentation. Through clinical examination and ultrasound, you can come to a conclusion regarding the chorionicity and amniocity, but zygosity can always be found out only through DNA studies. If the question specifically mentions that this is through dizygous twinning, the sex can be same or different. Whereas if it is because of monozygous twinning, it will always be the same sex. The confusion arises only in DCDA type of twin because it can arise from both dizygous and monozygous. If it is a generalized question, you can always select the option of same or different. If the question specifically mentions that the DCDA arises from monozygous twinning or that the fetus divides within 3 days of conception, you can go with the answer of always same gender. Thank you. These are my references.